जय हिंद एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रवीण एंड आई एम हियर कम विथ अ न्यू वीडियो एंड दिस वीडियो इज अबाउट द प्रीएम्बल ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। सो एवरीवन नोज दैट द प्रीएम्बल ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट वेरी फ्यू ऑफ अस रीड इट और वेरी फ्यू ऑफ अस हैव नॉलेज अबाउट द प्रीएम्बल ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन और एनी पार्ट ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। The preamble plays a very eminent role to know the constitution. Why? Because the N.A. Palkhiwala said that the preamble is an identity card of constitution. It means that preamble is an introduction to the Indian constitution. It is a preface to constitution. So, and very few of us read constitution or we have very less knowledge about our constitution. So I thought that I need to upload a video on preamble so that everyone knows and gain knowledge about our constitution and everyone gain knowledge about the preamble of constitution. So when Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru forwarded the objective resolution in Constituent Assembly, that time the Constituent Assembly accepted it, and after some time we know that objective resolution as a preamble of Indian constitution. And very few of us know that in Supreme Court judgment, Supreme Court said that the preamble is a part of Indian constitution and we can amend it. And when it was first amended in 1976, the one and only one time the preamble of Indian constitution is amended by the Parliament of India in 1976 by 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act. So we always say that the president is head of our state or head of government, or he don't have real power. So why it's so? So President of India is constitutional head, but the Prime Minister of India is having real power. Why so? Because he has a people's vote and he has people's trust. So preamble of India is start with the word "we, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure all its citizens' justice, social, economic and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuming the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation." In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adapt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution. So this whole thing is given in our preamble, and this is a word to word, this is a totally written in preamble. So why our freedom fighters, or we can say that the constitution makers, give this much huge preamble or wrote this much huge constitution? So our India is having various kind of people, their lives, and so much languages, difference in food, difference in regions, everything. But we always say that unity in a diversity. So the preamble of India also shows that unity in a diversity. We, the people of India, the preamble starts with this word. It means this Constitution is not only made by the constituent makers, but the people of India have their faith in this preamble, this constitution, and they made their own constitution to rule their own country. India is a democratic country, we all know that, and after every 5 years there are Lok Sabha elections, and we vote in that elections, and we choose or we give vote to choose our representative. We say that the member of parliament. So this is the thing we all have in our mind. Not only the constituent assembly's members, but also all over the India, the citizens of India thought that we need a constitution which gives equal opportunity, equal power, and which gives freedom to all the citizens. So the source of this constitution is the people of India, is the citizens of India. After that, the words are sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic. So these all words are there in India. It means India is not only a democracy, India is a republic. There is a difference between democracy and a republic. What the difference between these two words? See, we have democracy in Britain also, but Britain democracy is like a monarch. They have monarch. A few days before the monarch, Queen Elizabeth passed away, and now the King Henry, the new king is there now. So this is a difference between the British democracy and Indian democracy. So Indian people choose their own constitution head or their president, but British people can't choose their own constitutional head or their state head. So this is a difference between them. After every 5 years we have presidential elections also, and this year is going to be the presidential election year, and this year, so that's the thing. That's difference between the republic and monarchy. We have the Indian preamble has word sovereign. So what is the meaning of sovereign? Very few of us know that the difference between sovereign and democratic. Sovereign is a word which means that we are democracy, and no other country can affect our thought process or our laws, and any other which we make laws or code of conducts and our foreign policy, economic policy, nothing. The other countries can't affect on our foreign policy in any manner. So this is the thing, that no country can take over on our land or our institutions. So this is the meaning of sovereign. So friends, after this I will talk on other parts of constitution also, but as of I have the lack of time, because I need to prepare for my exams. And you all know that I cleared my CDS and FCAT exams twice, so and I am improving my communication skills day by day, so that I can secure more marks in my SSB interview. So please, if you like this video, then like it and share it with your friends, and please subscribe my channel, so that others who are having problem in Indian polity, they can also gain knowledge, and they can have more and more knowledge about the constitution, and they can improve their communication skills and their English language skills. So please like my channel video and subscribe my channel. Thank you once again. Jai Hind.